In this video, we are going to talk about the programmatic direct feature which is available in the Google Ad Manager. However, before discussing into this topic, let's go back to what we studied till now. Till now, we studied about the different types of line items. Till now, we studied about the orders that we created in the Google Ad Manager. So till now, basically, we studied about the traditional way of serving ads onto the web pages. By this I mean that there was a need for the publisher or the advertiser to reach out. For example, if the publisher wants to crack a deal with the advertiser, publisher sales team would reach out to the advertiser, negotiate with them offline, talk with them offline, and crack a deal. So this way the negotiation was complete and the advertiser would place an order with the publisher. And doing this, we would create an order, then we'll create line items, upload creatives to it. So there was a lot of communication that was happening offline. And there was a lot of email exchanges that took place between the advertisers and the publishers. Moreover, the advertiser needs to provide the creatives to the publisher. Publisher then takes the creative from the advertiser and traffics it in the Google Ad Manager. So there was a lot of trafficking time which was getting wasted. So to simplify this process, Google Ad Manager introduced programmatic direct in the Google Ad Manager, wherein the trafficking process is very simple and it is very time efficient. It is like, you know, the study according to the BCG declared that it saves 57% of the trafficking time of the traffickers so that you can concentrate on some other important things. Now here, the most important thing about the programmatic direct feature is that you don't have to communicate with the advertiser offline. Everything is handled by the Google interface itself. So there are a lot of buyers which are available in the Google Ad Manager. You can strike a proposal with any of the buyer, and if the buyer likes the proposal, they can have a deal with you. So this is how the programmatic direct goes in, or is about, this is how the programmatic direct is in the Ad Manager. So let's discuss now. For programmatic direct, there are some most important things that you should keep in mind, and this is the foundation wherein you will understand what exactly is programmatic direct, how is it transacted programmatically in the world of digital marketing. So let's get started and understand what exactly is programmatic. Now, programmatic direct is a one-to-one deal with the buyer. So you have one buyer, you have one publisher. So the buyer will negotiate with you online. The advertiser or the buyer will not have to communicate with the publisher offline. However, if he wishes to, he can communicate with the publisher, but only after cracking a deal. So it is basically a one-to-one deal with the buyer. In this, the most important thing is the creatives are hosted with the buyer. So as a publisher, you don't have to ask the creatives from the advertiser. You don't have to take the creatives from the advertiser and upload it in the Google Ad Manager. That means you are saving a lot of time. Here, creatives are hosted directly with the buyer in the UI. For example, buyer uses platforms like DBM or DV360, Trade Desk, or any other approved DSPs to host the creative. So creatives are with the advertiser itself. Advertiser decides which creative I should return back to the page. So the whole and sole owner of the creative is the advertiser. Before, in traditional serving, we uploaded the creatives. Ad manager would decide which creative should return back to the page and which creative should serve. Also, there were other settings in the Google Ad Manager, for example, like creative rotation, like evenly, optimized, weighted, sequential rotation were there, wherein we would rotate the type of the creatives that we want. So there was a lot of, the creatives were hosted in the publisher side, that is in the DFP, and we would decide what creative would serve on what page. But in this case, with programmatic direct, advertiser would decide what creative they would be returning back to the page whenever the user accesses the page. Now, another most important thing is to transact a programmatic direct deal, a bid request is sent from Google Ad Manager to the buyer, and the buyer decides to respond to the bid request sent to them. So there is no extra tagging required for the programmatic direct to transact. It will transact the same way as other standard line items that we used to transact in the traditional way of ad serving. It is just that instead of ad request, now ad request is fired from the Google publisher tags that are deployed on the page. Now this ad request is received by the Google Ad Manager. Once that is done, Google Ad Manager will send a bid request to the buyer's platform like DV360 or Trade Desk or any other platform. Now the buyer will understand or will receive this bid request and will respond to the bid request with the valid creative. So as the creatives are hosted with the buyer, they would respond with the creative. So in simple terms, you can remember it this way. Whenever we are transacting or whenever we are doing a programmatic direct in the Google Ad Manager, we should remember that a bid request is sent to the buyer and the buyer will respond to the bid request with a valid creative. After that, we just discussed this price. The buyer will need to respond to the bid request with the negotiated price that's been discussed between the publisher and the buyer. This price is nothing but the rate that we set in the line item. Rate could be CPM or CPD type. Now, when we create a line item in the Google Ad Manager, we know that we set up the rate. There is a field called as rate wherein we set up the rate. For example, if I want to sell for 1,000 impressions, I'm giving the rate as $5. That means advertiser will need to pay $5 per 1,000 impressions. So this is the rate that is set in the line item. So the buyer will need to respond to the bid request with this rate. If they do not respond, for example, let's discuss the next point. If the buyer bids with the price less than what is discussed, programmatic direct line item will not serve. Instead, ad manager will select the next best line item in the ad selection process. So this means that the buyer will have to bid with the price that is negotiated between them. They will have to bid with the price or the rate that is set in the line item in the Google Ad Manager. So buyer will be aware of this rate and they will have to bid with that price itself. If they bid more than, still they would be charged the same price itself. However, if they bid less than what is negotiated, then this programmatic direct line item will not serve on the page. Instead, some other line item which is in the ad selection process. So the next best eligible line item in the ad selection process would serve. So this is kind of a plan B. This is kind of a fallback in the Google Ad Manager. So this is to ensure that an unfilled impression is not served on the page. This is to ensure that the user always sees the ad and his experience is good when he accesses the page. So these are the basic things about the programmatic direct that you need to keep in mind. And there are two types of programmatic direct. Now, first thing is called as a programmatic guaranteed. Now, what does programmatic guaranteed stands for? Now, programmatic guaranteed is nothing but the guaranteed line items that are standard and sponsorship. That means you can set up a standard and sponsorship guaranteed line items. Standard and sponsorship programmatic guaranteed line items in the ad manager and negotiate a deal with the buyer, with the desired buyer with whom you want to strike a deal with. Now, when we talk about standard and sponsorship, this means that the inventory is reserved because these are guaranteed and the buyer is obligated to bid to every bid request that is sent to them. That means ideally the buyer should bid to each and every bid request that the ad manager is sending to their platforms. That is why this is called as the programmatic guaranteed. Ideally they should bid. Programmatic guaranteed, it does not mean that the delivery is guaranteed, it just means that the inventory is guaranteed. You should remember this point because this is very important. People usually have a notion that when we set up a programmatic guaranteed deal in the ad manager, they assume that the line item will always deliver in full no matter what the competition is. It does not mean like that. It simply means that the inventory is reserved, just like the normal standard and line items that we discussed so far, that we discussed till now. Before this video, so you can set up standard and sponsorship programmatic line items in the ad manager and you can make the inventory as reserved for the buyer. Another point, to transact the programmatic guaranteed deal or line item successfully, it is the responsibility of both the buyer and the seller. Buyer needs to ensure that they respond to the bid request with the discussed price and with a valid creative. Now, what happens when the buyer does not respond with a valid creative? If they do not respond with a valid creative, then the programmatic line item, be it standard or sponsorship, will not serve on the page. Instead, the next best eligible line item would serve. So that means there is a fall of delivery, or this programmatic line item could go under delivering or underperforming. So it is a responsibility. So in order for the line items to transact and ensure that the line item serve its full goal of impression, it is a responsibility of both the buyer and the seller. Seller needs to send the bid request to the buyer. That means the ad manager will send a bid request to the buyer, so the publisher will actually don't have to worry about sending a bid request. It is done automatically. They don't have to do anything manually here. However, buyer will need to respond with the valid creative, and if they do not do so, the programmatic line item will get rejected in the ad selection process. Let's come to the next point. We discussed this before also. Creatives are hosted with the advertiser in their platforms like DV360 or DVM. So creatives will not be uploaded in DFP. In short, there is a lot of trafficking time which is saved, and the traffickers can invest their time in something very urgent and in optimizing the line items or the orders which are of more important to them. This was about the programmatic guaranteed line items. This is the one type of the programmatic direct. The next type of the programmatic direct is called as the preferred deals. Now, preferred deal is a non-guaranteed type, means you don't have to reserve the inventory for the buyer, and the buyer is also not obligated to bid for every bid request that we send to them. So it is up to the buyer. They choose whether to bid or not to bid, and they are not even bothered about the deliverables, about how and when the impression should be served. So for those type of buyers, it is good to have a preferred deal. You can negotiate programmatically with them and set up a line item in the Google Ad Manager. Now this line item will be called as preferred deal line item type. So when you set up a line item in the Google Ad Manager, you will need to select the line item type as preferred deal. Now this is about the preferred deal, which has the ability to transact programmatically. Here also you can select any buyer, create a proposal in the Google Ad Manager, send it to them, and if the buyer likes the proposal, they can accept it, and you can start a deal. You can start setting up the line items, you can start transacting the deal without any issues. So this was about the preferred deals. Let's get started with the other important things. Now, how does the billing happen? Now, billing is handled directly by the Google here. So either both the advertiser and the publisher should not get worried, because the advertisers will pay according to the impressions recorded in their DV360 UI or in any other platforms in which they are hosting the creatives. And the publishers will get paid by the Google on the number of impressions recorded in the DFP. So the billing is handled directly by the Google. So the amount will be deducted from the advertiser automatically, and it will be credited to the publisher's account automatically. So there is no loss. So also the publisher will not have to reach out to the advertiser for the payments, and they don't need to follow up with the advertiser for the payments. So this is happening seamlessly, and this is a seamless process, and there will be a less headache for both the advertiser and the publisher, because at the end, advertiser is only paying for those impressions which have recorded in their system, and the publisher is getting the money for the impressions recorded in DFP. And when you use programmatic direct, the discrepancy between the buyer number and the publisher number is under 3%. So there will be impression discrepancy will not be more in when you transact programmatically. So you actually don't have to worry about the discrepancy that could take place between the publisher's impression number and the DV360's impression number. And the discrepancy can be put under 3%. And if you see a discrepancy of more than 3%, you can reach out to the Google team, and they will be able to investigate the discrepancy and give you the relevant info about why it happened. And if it happens, they can return back your money too. So this was about the programmatic direct. This was just a foundation course, and these are some of the important things that you should remember, because in our next video, we will get started with creating the programmatic direct line items in the UI. We will see how they are created, under which tab they should be created, because we will not be creating programmatic direct line items under the delivery tab. So there is a slightly different process on where they should be created. So let's see in our next video. Till then, thank you so much.